Hello everybody. Welcome to Number One Doctor Channel. Today video is about urinary retention and incontinence, which is part of our playlist called Short Medical Notes, in which we will have short videos about important topic in medicine. But please do not forget to like and share our videos and subscribe to our YouTube channel Number One Doctor, and join our social media accounts in the links below each video. Our aim is to share the correct medical knowledge for all for free. Share and be shared. Today we will talk about urinary retention and incontinence. Acute urinary retention is seen very commonly in men who already have significant symptoms from benign prostatic hypertrophy. It is often precipitated during a cold, by the use of antihistamines and nasal drops, and by abundant fluid intake. The patient wants to void but cannot, and the huge distended bladder is palpable. An indwelling bladder catheter needs to be placed and left in for at least 3 days. First line of long-term therapy is alpha blockers, the most selective of which is tamsulosin. 5-alpha reductase inhibitors, like finasteride or dutasteride, are used for very large glands more than 40 grams. Minimally invasive procedures using thermal ablation of prostatic tissue have not gained popularity. The traditional transurethral resection of the prostate TURP, although rarely done, remains the final surgical option for benign prostatic hypertrophy. Postoperative urinary retention is also very common, and sometimes it masquerades as incontinence. The patient may not feel the need to void because of post-op pain, medications, etc., but will report that every few minutes there is involuntary release of small amounts of urine. A huge distended bladder will be palpable, confirming that the problem is overflow incontinence from retention. Indwelling bladder catheter is needed. Stress incontinence is also very common. It is seen in middle-aged women who have had many pregnancies and vaginal deliveries. They leak small amounts of urine whenever intra-abdominal pressure suddenly increases. This includes sneezing, laughing, getting out of a chair, or lifting a heavy object. They do not have any incontinence during the night. Examination will show a weak pelvic floor, with the prolapsed bladder neck outside of the high-pressure abdominal area. Surgical repair of the pelvic floor is indicated in advanced cases with large cystocels. Pelvic floor exercises may be sufficient for early cases. Thanks for watching our video and hope to see you again in next videos. Do not forget to see other videos in our channel. With my best wishes, Dr. Atef Ahmed.